Welcome, and on this video we're doing a product review for the Aldebaran NAO robot. So if you want to see how this little fellow is changing the way that schools are teaching children about robotics, then stay tuned. Hi guys, I'm Philip English from RoboPhil.com. Now on this video we're looking into the Aldebaran NAO robot. The NAO robot comes from a company called Aldebaran, and they were first founded back in 2005. They're currently about 450 employees, and 40% of the employees are research and development. There's 5 offices around the world for Aldebaran, including Boston, Los Angeles and Paris. There's over 6,000 NAOs around the world now in 60 different countries, and it is the worldwide leader in human robotics. The main use for the NAO robot is in schools, colleges and unities for education tools. The purpose of the NAO is to motivate students, improve learning effectiveness and teach in a job creating field. Aldebaran has already produced 2 other robots, one called Romeo and the other one called Pepper, so you can see how quickly the robot industry is progressing. So to give you a physical overview of the NAO, he's got 25 degrees of freedom, smooth and precise coreless motors controlled by the software, and complex movement capabilities. For his sensors, he's got 2 HD cameras, 4 microphones, 8 force sensitive resistors, internal sensors, 2 bumpers and 2 sonars. For his interaction, he has 2 loudspeakers, multiple LEDs, tactile sensors, prehensile hands, infrared sensors and Wi-Fi connectivity. For the thinking part of NAO, i.e. his brains, he's got an Intel Atom 1.6 GHz CPU, 1 GB worth of RAM, 8 GB flash memory, and it comes with a complete software suite. The reason why NAO is the most worldwide used humanoid robot is that he's fully and easily programmable, autonomous and interactive, affordable, compatible with all the standards, so i.e. multi-languages, C++, Python, MATLAB, Java and LabVIEW, and is also very robust. Now as I've discussed already, NAO is mainly used in education for teaching kids about their computer science, their IT, their mechatronics, their electronics, their engineering, but there are other areas where NAO can be useful. In the human assistive side, we've got a complete autistic program for NAO, and even on the elderly side for people with Alzheimer's. There's the surveillance side of NAO, so obviously he can monitor people, he can do home care, and obviously the entertainment side, where we've all seen already where he does his dances, and you can use that for shows and games and even some hotels. And NAO comes with a complete software suite with 4 different applications. Starting with Choreograph, which is the learning part, which is similar to Scratch, a simple drag and drop program to actually get the child to learn how to control the robot. Monitor is access to the NAO's data and his motors, so you can see what's going on internally in NAO. Comes with a 3D simulator, so you can have a 3D NAO wandering around the room. And obviously the software development kit for all your programming needs. One of the personal services you get with NAO is there's lots of educational content out there that's come out. You get user training, so when you first get your NAO. There's a massive community of NAO users, so they can help you out with different codes and even team up in a group to produce a certain program. And there's lots of support and maintenance. And NAO is used in many different types of education establishments. Talking about primary schools, secondary schools, colleges and universities. There's even a few nurseries that are starting to take on NAO, and obviously there's also other research platforms that NAOs are getting used for.